Hello everyone, welcome to TEDx Depressed Nurse. Myself Dila Bandane, and today I am here to present my views on social media. That is, we'll check two sides of social media, good and evil. So, what is social media? In simple definition, social media is a computer-based technology that enables the sharing of ideas, thoughts and information through the building of virtual networks and communities. In short, it is a platform where anyone around the world can share his views, talents, videos, etc. So, what are the known examples of it? Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and our favorite Google Baba, and much more. It will take a lifetime to say all these names. The reason I chose this topic because after Jio revolution in India, there has been boom in users of net as well as the amount of data we use. Now let us know about it using graph. Social networks users in India from 14 crore in 2015 has increased nearly 40 crore in 2021. Average data consumption in India has increased from 2 GB per month to 11 GB from 2015 to 2020, according to the report by Ericsson. Now, let us talk about good things of social media. Social media has helped us to connect with each other by breaking the distance barrier. No pigeon messenger, we have high-speed email, or maybe a video call will do. It has helped us in exchange of ideas, which in return has helped us in completing our homework, project, which we mostly do at last time by copy-pasting from Google Baba, right? Everyone will agree with that. Well, this talk was prepared by myself. Social media has been an important part of our entertainment, like funny videos, movies, drama, vlogs, documentaries, songs, etc. It has created social media stars on various platforms and many idiots on TikTok who are now on Insta stories. Entertainment aside, social media has become an important part of government policies like schemes, awareness about law and rules of our country have been widely published using social media. Example, railway complaints are now being solved in minutes using it. It has also been useful for poor people because many good people have come forward by listening to their stories on it. It has created multi-billion advertisement industry, and not but least, it has given many artists, designers, housewives to start their own online business of selling jewelry, foods, items, textiles and whatnot. The list of good is now long. Now let us move towards evil parts. We all know that social media like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Google, etc. are free. So how do they make money? Well, short answer, the famous quote, if you are not paying for it, you are the product. All the social media platforms are continuously using your info for advertisement. Example, a quick search on Facebook for shoes, you start getting ads of shoes. Companies from e-commerce portal, and private info is being continuously sold to companies by big tech companies to get money from advertising. Android users are be aware because your info has made Google a $1 trillion company. Privacy and social media are not connected. Take the case of Facebook on WhatsApp. First they use privacy as bid to gain users. Now they want to sell data. A quick check on companies using your data for making money. Facebook total revenue nearly 98.5% is from ads. Alphabet, the parent company of Google, nearly 70.4% is from ads. Social media has now become a tool for fraud. The fraud of job, information stealing, fake money, making schemes and many more. Your parents may have received a message of winning crores of rupees on social media. Beware, never to post your personal details on social media. Cyberbullying, trolling, women harassment has taken new root. The stalkers are now using social media as a platform to troll, bully and harass women and children. Fake news cause has been to rise in India. They are being used to create hatred among communities and also incite violence. Example of farmer protest, in which certain politician, media and anchor news website posted fake news of farmer's death from police firing, which create a mob rampage in India. Social media addiction has been a problem in India. Many people are suffering from depression because of it. I would really like to show you a short video on Facebook founder being asked to share his private info.
Mr. Zuckerberg, would you be comfortable sharing with us the name of the hotel you stayed in last night?
No.
If you messaged anybody this week, would you share with us the names of the people you've messaged?
Senator, no, I would probably not choose to do that publicly here.
I think that might be what this is all about. Your right to privacy, the limits of your right to privacy, and how much you give away in modern America in the name of, quote, connecting people around the world. Question basically of what information Facebook's collecting, who they're sending it to, and whether they ever asked me in advance my permission to do that. Is that a fair thing for a user of Facebook to expect?
Yes, Senator. I think everyone should have control over how their information is used.
By looking at the good and evil aspect of social media, we can see that social media is a double-edged sword. It is in the hands of users how to control it properly. I would like to say that please stop posting your status unnecessarily on social media, because you may not know when it will become an addiction and what's the use of showing your personal life to someone. Please don't compare life with someone's fake life on social media, because 99% of the stars you admire are fake. Enjoy your life in real world. Thank you.